Oh, you don't. You're not. That couldn't be it.
What do you think you got?
I think I actually managed to dodge his attack while I was between his legs, but nah, I don't think so. Okay. Never mind. I had a brief moment of thinking I had figured something out.
Well, it seems possible. You just gotta move quick.
Which?
But maybe not.
It just seems weird that they would put that spot there and not have it be used.
I wonder, does he always duck left and duck right?
I think so. Woo! I dodged the blast.
Oh wow, you don't even need to duck the medium wave.
Well, you have to do the running duck.
Oh.
Okay, I think I'm... I think I'm on the... now. I think I've got it.
Of course, it would help if the grenades would actually hit, but... And that's not your fault, by the way. The grenades... the hit detection on those grenades against this particular boss is kind of like, well, hit or miss.
I just can't imagine hitting him with any other weapon, though.
Now you'd have to get, like, ridiculously close to hit him with the whip sword thing. And I don't even see a way to hit him with the gun.
Yeah.
Although, well, no. There's not enough time with the, when he lowers his arms. Because the first thing he does is launch a high wave, so...
Oh, shit.
Shite, fuck! That background is amazing, though, huh?
Yeah, I know. Look at that parallax scrolling. Suck it, Yahtzee. That's gonna be my ongoing joke in this stream. Or no, I'm doing a what is it when you bring back a joke?
Callback?
Callback, thank you. To earlier in the stream. He has that fucking damn Bowser stomp, too.
This boss is weird.
Boss is the fucking Terminator. With a Bowser stomp. He's just not landing on his butt. That's like the only difference.
And he hops on one leg. Well, leaps. I'm using one leg. So wait a minute, if you guys are clones of each other, shouldn't you be able to do this too?
You think. I just don't know how yet, I guess.
Well, first you have to submit to the Dark Hado. Completely random reference.
I'm willing to buy that reference, though. It probably helps that I am a huge Street Fighter fan, so...
Or maybe you have to summon Zool.
There is no Dana, only Zool. Or if this is a Nostalgia Critic review, Zool, motherfucker, Zool! That's one of the possible... My wife owes me a Corgi sometime in the future.
Go ahead.
I don't want one right now since I have, you know, obviously too many pets. But one of the possible names that I'll name my future Corgi is Zool.
Why would you do that? Also, you were so damn close, God!
I was. I think it was because I kind of zoned out and was talking about, like...
Corgi.
Yeah.
But Corgis are very distracting.
But yeah, I'm honestly thinking that I might name it Zul.
And again, why? Why would you do that? It'd
be awesome.
Come here, Zul. Come here, boy.
I mean, come on, it's a quirky named Zul. Better than the name my daughter would want and wants to name a quirky.
Like, what?
Two names. One is Thorgy.
Thorgy?
Thorgy.
You know, like, dorky.
Like, no, Thorgy. Like Thor, except as a quirky.
No, I got it. That's why I said, how dorky.
Yeah. The other one is, the other one is Chicken.
I don't.
Because we have a dog named Waffle, so then we'd have Waffle and Chicken and Waffle.
That's horrible.
Yeah.
Your daughter is fired.
So, yeah, I kind of want to call it Zul. I think it'd be awesome. There's another name that we thought of that I can't remember right now. But... Pancake was another name that we thought of, which if we were going with something that would go with Waffle, I think that would be a far more fitting choice.
I don't know. Have you ever had Chicken and Waffles?
Yeah.
Like, really?
Yeah, they have it at IHOP.
Oh, right. I think they have Chicken and Waffles at Popeye, too.
Yep. And Church's Chicken, I think, has started that, too. Except there's this, like, chicken and waffle bites or something.
Oh, yeah. Like, why? If you're gonna have chicken and waffles, have chicken and waffles. Don't be, like, little bite-sized chunks. But, I've actually never had chicken and waffles. It sounds good.
It's good. It's a nice mix of savory and sweet. It's actually really interesting.
It's like, to me, it's kind of like steak and eggs, you know?
Yeah. Because it's pretty much like chicken... You know, battered chicken strips with waffles.
That actually sounds really good. Like I thought it would.
Though I can't think of that without thinking of this. Have you ever heard of Tokyo Breakfast?
That sounds familiar. Go on.
It was this Japanese, like, pilot.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to go into it because it says a word that I prefer not to say a lot. So I'm just going to say, everybody look up Tokyo Breakfast on YouTube.
Do it. You won't regret it.
Moo did.
Well. Wait, really?
Yeah. He almost couldn't make it through the whole thing. It was like just like, I can't. And I was like, come on, just make it to the final part. But I love that. I will say my favorite part is the scene where she's like, I made your favorite meal. Chicken and waffles. It's like chicken and waffles, but it's all cut up in like the Japanese serving style.
That thing was too good.
I can understand why that pilot didn't fly, not just for the... reason I can't talk about in this video, but because of I don't see how that joke would really fly for a whole series.
Yeah, that's more like a, you know, it's a one shot, or maybe
like
occasional.
Like a skit on a, it'd be like a skit on a variety show, maybe.
Exactly.
Yeah, like the ending though to that, Moo almost lost it. If you remember how that ended.
I do.
Okay. Yeah, he pretty much like, oh no, a black guy came in. Oh, fucking no. He's like, I've never felt so offended by a bunch of Asians before in my entire life. I think was what he said.
Ah, he shouldn't feel offended. He should feel honored. Or maybe not.
Fill all classes except animation.
Oh Like I said, that was just too good. It's one of those things. Good.
I was just gonna say it's so hard to reference it without saying the thing that makes me not want to. That makes up most of it.
Yeah. I mean, suffice to say, it's a hot topic these days. Come to think of it, this sort of thing would definitely not fly over here.
It's the one word that JonTron said in Game Grumps that got bleeped out.
You know, I always wondered about that.
Yeah.
That actually happened in Achievement Hunters a few times too, where, you know, they started egging each other on. Like, you know, well, this conversation turned dark, or this conversation turned weird, or whatever. And it actually got even worse. So they had to bleep it out. And it looks like you won.
Cannot destroy it. What's it? Every dog has its day. What does that even fucking mean in this revelation?
Context? So see, you should be able to...
He kind of looks like Gargamel when he's on the ground. Oh, this is totally Ninja Gaiden.
Yep, there goes the, not the Dark Tower.
Dude, my guy kind of looks like Leisure Suit Larry in this picture.
Yes, he does.
So...
Wait, holy crap. Full names.
Yep.
Usually it's just like initial last name or
Fishman.
Pseudonyms. Fishman, yeah.
I always was disappointed. Oh, there you go, Ninko. I always was disappointed that they never made an actual Fishman in the game. The end. I guess they're trying to hint that there could be a sequel, but it never happened because nobody bought this game, and I don't understand why. And I can't believe I beat it because this game is awesome.
And it was made well. You said. Did you say this was made by or produced by?
Distributed.
Oh, distributed.
Possibly produced by American Sammy. I know the actual programming team, I think, is ICOM.
ICOM?
Yeah.
As in, like, Shadowgate?
A-I-C-O-M.
As in, like, Shadowgate?
No, not ICOM. That's I-C-O-M. It's A-I-C-O-M.
Oh, ICOM. Well, actually, yeah, you're right. That'd also be ICOM.
See, I know they've made other games, but I can't remember off the top of my head. Regardless, this game is badass.
Absolutely.
And I actually feel incredibly accomplished for beating it. Since it's a game I've never beaten before, I haven't even played as far as... Like, remotely close as far as I did. Well, of course not as far as I did, but I mean... Like I said, I think previously I played, like, the first... level or something. And was like, this is really cool, I need to come back to it, and never did. Because when you collect NES games, you buy a lot of NES games. And when you sit down to play one for nostalgic reasons, you're more often to grab Mega Man 2 or Super Mario Bros. 3 or something like that.
You're gonna laugh. One of the other games ICOM did, totally rad. Oh, but they also did the Astyanax, which is pretty cool.
Wow.
And...
They've got an interesting resume here.
So, yeah, basically, a lot of these little NES games that maybe nobody's ever played, or maybe only a few people have. They did Viewpoint? Holy shit!
Viewpoint.
That was the isometric shooter.
Yeah, that one was actually kind of cool.
Yeah, even the Genesis version of that game is really awesome.
Okay, I will say at least one thing for this. Not all of ICOM games may have been great, but they, when you think about it, they're all pretty graphically impressive for the NES. Because even Totally Rad has some pretty impressive graphics for the NES.
Yeah. Astyanax, not so much, but...
It had pretty big characters, which was rare at the time, so...
That's true. Big characters, big bosses.
Lots of flicker, though.
Lots of flicker.
It's still impressive, since that was like one of their earlier titles. Let's see.
And the rest of these, most of these are like sports games. Although, like you said, there's Amagon.
Amagon? They made Amagon?
Yeah, they made Amagon.
It's a decent game.
Or if you prefer the Japanese version, Tuzen Macho Man!
I think I like the Japanese name better.
They also did the Moffat Conspiracy.
Oh, the sequel to Gullah Gullah 13.
Yeah.
I actually like that one better than Gullah Gullah 13, though. I don't know if everybody would agree with me on that.
Yeah, and it is Gullah Gullah 13, The Riddle of Icarus in Japan, so...
Released by Vic Tyco.
Vic Tyco. Tokai.
Tokai, sorry. Vic Tokai. That made a game that I really like that I wouldn't mind streaming at one point, though I would totally have to get a walkthrough because there's no way I would remember everywhere I need to go in that game.
Oh no. This is a sniping segment in the Moffat Conspiracy.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Well, they had to. There were sniping segments in Gullah Gullah 13, so...
Oh no.
But no, when I was saying a game that Vic Tokai released that I would like to stream, but I'd have to, because I really love the game, but I'd totally have to get a walkthrough before I could do it, is Clash of Demon Head. I fucking love that game.
Bang.
Bang. But it's like a case where I'd have to get a walkthrough because that game gets really...
convoluted?
For lack of better words. It's got a large map. And there's just not really any way to really remember everything unless you've got one hell of a good memory. And there's
is it more confusing than Blaster Master?
Well, okay.
On the same level?
No, not really. Because what it is it's got kind of a map screen, kind of like Super Mario Brothers. And Super Mario Brothers 3, except it doesn't give you any names to any of the locations. So you'll find someone in one area, and they'll say, you need to go to route such and such to find such and such, but there's nothing that tells you which one's route such and such until you actually go to it.
Ooh, I see.
So, yeah. The only reason I was able to beat it as a kid is that Nintendo Power had a map that showed which route was what. And that made things significantly less convoluted and significantly less frustrating.
Sounds about right.
Anyways, this was a great stream. I mean, may have only had four people, but I don't give a shit. I beat this game, and it was fun all the way through. I mean, I admit I did cheat at the end part. I used the save states, but I don't think anybody fucking blames me.
Nah, I mean, who could blame you?
And
with practice, you could probably beat it, you know... Again, yeah. Without save states. Because, I mean, I don't know how you managed to do that, but you kept getting grenades from out of nowhere.
Oh, yeah, it's something I figured out. I think you're supposed to beat him with grenades, because I noticed that whenever I'd run out of grenades, they would regenerate slowly back.
Yeah, you kept getting two grenades out of thin air. And in his previous form, you kept getting five bullets out of thin air when you ran out.
So I think, I think they were. You're supposed to use those weapons, and they're actually not being dicks and putting you in a no-win situation.
Which is great.
Yeah.
That was really thoughtful.
Yeah, and this is just a really fucking well-made game. I still say it's a real pity that it didn't get the attention it deserved.
Yeah, it's like coming into this, you know, from Ninja Gaiden, you're like. Ninja Gaiden, it's a Ninja Gaiden-like game. I'm like, yeah, this is like Ninja Gaiden if they get the physics wrong. But the more you play it, I was like, this isn't Ninja Gaiden. There's a lot of similarities, but this is its own thing.
Yeah.
And it's a really good thing, too.
Yeah. It's definitely got... you can't say they weren't inspired by Ninja Gaiden,
They were most definitely inspired by Ninja Gaiden, but in turn, I think Ninja Gaiden 3 might have taken some inspiration from this. Don't quote me on this, because they were released two months apart, but there is some similarity.
Anyways, Hope everybody enjoyed the stream. I certainly did. I still can't believe I beat this game. I was expecting not to achieve it. So,
congratulations, man.
I think we need to do Shatterhand at some point, though. Definitely want to do that.
Hell yeah.
Until next time, though. See ya.
See ya.